Hello everyone and welcome to Coding Cart. So in this session we'll try to understand one hacker rank problem. So you can see here the problem name is frequency queries. So let me first explain you this problem in a simple way what they are saying. So here we will be given Q queries, for example Q queries, and each query contains two values. One is the operation and another is the value, and there are three types of operation: operation 1, 2 and 3. Suppose the operation is 1, then what we have to do? We have to insert that values in a certain data structure what we are going to take. If the operation is 2, then we have to delete one occurrence of y from your data structure if it is present. And if the operation is 3, then we have to check if any integer present in our data structure whose frequency is exactly equal to z. Then we have to print yes, otherwise you have to print 0. So for example, suppose my operation is 1 and the value is 10. So what we have to do here? We have to insert in our data structure. So for example, I am taking a list as my data structure. For example, then I have to insert here 10. Now another operation, suppose this is my query 1. Query 2 is, suppose I am taking value 2 and 20. Then it is saying that this is my operation number 2. We have to delete one occurrence of y from our data structure if it is present. So you can see here the value here is y is 20. Then we have to delete one occurrence of 20 from our data structure. So you can see here 20 is not present, so we don't have to do anything. I'm taking third example. Suppose my operation is 3 and my value is, suppose, 10. So you can see here for operation 3, we have to check if any integer is present whose frequency is exactly equal to z. Here my frequency is how much? 10. So is there any value whose frequency is exactly equal to 10? No, we have only value 10 whose frequency is only 1. So we have to return here how much? 0. Let me take another example. Suppose I have operation 1 and value 2. Again operation 1, value 2. Operation 1, value 2. Now operation 2 with value, suppose, 2. Operation 3 with value, suppose, 2. So these are my queries: first, second, third, fourth and 5. Now suppose I have taken a data structure as a list. So the very first is operation is 1, and for 1 we have to insert x in our data structure. So we inserted x. This is x. Now second query is again operation 1 and we have to insert 2. Let us insert 2. And query is in query 3, operation is 1 and we have to insert the value. For operation 1 we have to insert the value 2. Now we are done here. For query 4, the operation is 2. So for operation 2, they have written delete one occurrences of y from your data structure. So you can see here y have occurred how many times? This is my y, and here y have occurred how many times? 3 times. So we have to delete one occurrences of y. So after deletion it will become 2. Let us delete this one. Now we are done with this query. In query 5, the operation is 3. Now the value here is 2. So we have to check if any integer in our data structure whose frequency is exactly equal to z. This is my z value. So you can see here there are integers here whose value is 2 and its occurrence is how much? 2, which is exactly equal to z. If it is present, then we have to return 1. So this is our answer, 1. So from this problem statement it is clear that we have to use dictionary as there is a requirement of the frequency. Suppose for the same problem if I can use a dictionary, then you can see occurrence of 2, that key will be 2 and its occurrence will be how much? 3. for the query number 4, they are saying that delete one occurrences of y from your data structure. Then we can easily delete one from the occurrences of key 2. And for operation 3, we can easily check in our dictionary values. If any values is equal to z, then we can simply return 1 as our answer. So it is clear that we have to use dictionary as our data structure. Now let us take another example. For example, there are 4 queries. There are 4 queries and the values are 3, 4, operation 2 having values 100, operation 1 having value suppose 16, operation 3 and having value 1. So we have to take a dictionary type data structure. Now you can see here. For the very first, the operation is what? 3. And 3, we have to check if any integer is present whose frequency is exactly equal to z. Here z is how much? This is my z. Value is how much? 4. Here nothing is present, so it will simply print 0 as our answer. Now we are done with the very first query. Second query is 2. So for 2, they have written delete one occurrences of y from your data structure if it is present. So nothing is present in my dictionary, it is empty. So nothing will happen here. We will go for the next query. Next query, the operation is 1 and we have to simply add this value. So we can simply add 16 as our key and its occurrences as a value in our dictionary. Now we are done with this query. Now the last query is 3 and 1. Here operation is 3 and the value here for z is 1. So you can see here there is a value 16 whose occurrence is how much? 1, which is equal to z. Means they are saying that check if any integer is present whose frequency is exactly equal to z. So you can see here an integer is present 16 whose frequency is 1, which is exactly equal to the z value which is given. So we have to return 1 as our answer. So for this query our answer will be 0 and 1. So this is the problem. So the approach is quite simple. We will simply take a dictionary and we follow the step given here over here. So let us write the code. So we have to complete this function frequency query. They are providing us the queries. So they will provide this sample input as a queries. So let us write the code. So the very first thing is we will simply take a counter from collection to import counter. Now we have to write our logic over here. We will take one result variable as a list in which we will append our result to return like this one. At last we have to return the result. So let us save that in a result. Now let us take the dictionary as our data structure. Now we are done with the two things. Next thing is we have to iterate through queries. So for the query will contain, here the queries is in a list type. And each list have two values. One is the operation and another is the value. Means one is the operation and another is the value. So for operation comma value in queries. Now we will check if the operation is 1, if op equal to 1, then we have to write the logic. So we have to write our logic for the insertion. So DC, our key will be the value here. Our key will be value. If it is present, then it will simply add 1 to the counter. If it is not present, then it will treat as a key and upgrade the value with 1. Means initially my dictionary is empty. Suppose I am getting the value as query 1 and value 10. So initially my dictionary is empty. So what I am doing here, I have to add this 10 as my key. If it is present, then it will simply update the value with plus 1. If it is not present, it will treat this as a key and update the value with 1. Now we are done with the very first operation. Now we have to check L if my operation is 2. If it is 2, then we have to check the value. If DC of value, the value present at that key greater than 0. If it is greater than 0, then we have to subtract 1 from the frequency. They are saying that here, delete 1 occurrences of Y. You can see here, they are saying there, delete 1 occurrences of Y from your data structure if it is present. Suppose this is the case. Suppose the value is 10 and its occurrences is 1. In next query, I am getting operation 2 and value has suppose 1. And again, I have one query whose operation is 2 and value is 1. Then you can see here, it will go in my dictionary. Here operation is 2. For 2, we are deleting the frequency, one frequency if it is present. Value is suppose 10 here. So you can see here, value is 10. It will go and treat this value as a key. Yes, 10 is present. Then I have to decrease this counter by 1. Now it will become 0. Now next time, in next query, I have the operation 2 and value is again 10. So you can see here, here the frequency is 0. That's why I have written here, we have to check whether the value present at that key is greater than 0 or not. If it is greater than 0, then only we have to subtract. Because if you simply subtract this value, it will become 10 and value will be minus 1. Because 10 is present as a key, but value is here 0. If you write the logic like, let me comment this one first. DC of value minus equal to 1. So if I am writing a logic like without checking whether this dictionary value greater than 0 or not, then we will be getting here value as minus 1. Because it won't check whether the value is greater than 0 or not. It will simply subtract 1. That's why we are writing here, we have to first check if the value is, value present at that key is greater than 0, then only we have to subtract 1. Two operations are done. Now if the operation is not 1, not 2, then it is obvious that it is 3. So else we have to check, the third condition is, we have to check if any integer whose integer is present whose frequency is exactly equal to z, then we have to print yes. If yes, then we have to print 1, else we have to print 0. So let us check here, if value in dc dot values. what we are doing here is suppose this is my dictionary. Suppose key is 2, its occurrences is 2. Key is 3, its occurrences is 5. Key is suppose 10, which have occurred only twice. For 15, its occurrence is suppose 1. So this is my dictionary. And I have a requirement of operation is 3 and my z value is suppose here 2. So they are saying that, is there any integer present in my dictionary whose frequency is exactly equal to z, means 2. So you can see here there are two integer 2 and 10 whose frequency is exactly equal to z, which is 2. So what I am doing here, I will simply take out the values from my dictionary and I will check whether this 2 is present in my values or not. Means my values here will be 2, 5, 2 and 1. This will be in a list. This value will be in list and I am simply checking whether this z is present in my list or not. So you can see here z is present. If it is present, I will simply append 1. So this will return me a list. This value is a list. Now if it is present, then I have to simply append my result. I have to simply append 1, else I have to append 0. So we are done with our logic and at last we have to return the result. So quite easy. So let us run and see. So you can see here we are done with the sample test cases. So let us submit this code. It is taking too much of time. So you can see here we got TLE. Out of 14 test cases, only one is failing here, test case 11. So let me explain you why it is failing for one test case. So if you see here in this else condition, this part, let me explain you here. Suppose I have a 10 to the power 5, what is the constant over here? So you can see our query is to 10 to the power 9. Suppose I am taking only example for 10 to the power 5. Out of these, I have a suppose operation 3 of type suppose so out of this 10 to the power 5 I have a type 3 operation suppose 10 to the power 3 times. So 10 to the power 3 times, for example, I am only saying 10 to the power 3 times I have to go in my dictionary and have to get the values. You can see here in the code here, line number 20 here. So each time I have to take dictionary dot values, means each time it will return me a list. So this returning a list will take a space and I'm checking value in my list. So checking this value in a list, suppose I am take values means here z, each time I'm checking this z in my list, means it is taking on space for returning as the list type, and in this space we are checking this z value, which will take order of n each time. That's why it is failing over here. For this line only it is failing. This will return as a list, and in this list we are checking the value. So how to overcome this? So let me explain you here by another example. Suppose I have a dictionary 1 having value, suppose 10 as my key and its occurrence is only 2. Let me first write. And suppose again my key is 9, whose occurrence is 2. This is my dictionary 1. Now, what we will do, we will take another dictionary. As you know, searching in dictionary is order of 1. In our code here, the searching is only taking time. So what we will do here, we will take another dictionary, dictionary 2, and we will keep these values as a key, and these values occurrences as my value. So you can see here, from dictionary 1 I will take the values as my key. So your key will be 2, whose occurrences are, you can see here, for 2 we have three occurrences. Now for key 3 we have 2 occurrences, you can see here. For key 1 the occurrence is 1. Now suppose I am getting one operation, like for example 2n, the value is suppose 2. Here operation is 2 and my y value is here 2. So for operation 2 they have said we have to check whether there is any value present, not value. For operation 2 we have to delete one occurrences of y from our data structure. So is there any key for 2? No. So nothing will happen here. Suppose my operation is here 2 and my y value is suppose here, suppose 10. So now you can see here, 10 is present in my dictionary 1. Yes, 10 is present. So what we have to do here? We have to delete one occurrences of this value 10. So here my occurrences will be how much? 1. Now my dictionary 1 got changed. So if you see here, 1 have occurred twice. So then I have to again update this dictionary 2. My key will be 1 and its occurrence is how much? Updated with value 2. And again you will see here, the occurrences of 2 has decreased, means we have deleted the one occurrences. Then again I have to update this dictionary 2 as well, its occurrences will be 2. Now suppose my operation is 3 and the value is, for example, suppose 2. So for operation 3 they are saying that is there any values in my dictionary whose occurrences is exactly equal to this value z. So you can see here, instead of searching in this dictionary, we'll directly go in dictionary 2 and treat this as a key. So if I treat this as a key, so you can see here 2 is there, 2 my key is present over here. If it is present, I will simply return 1 as my answer. So this will take only order of 1. No need to take the values as a list. No need to take the value as a list. And again in this list I have to search for this z. This taking list was taking time, and searching was also taking time in order of n. So we'll simply take one more dictionary and work accordingly. So let me first take one example how these things will work. Now let us take this queries as an example. So there are 10 queries. So let us take this as an example. So what we will do, we will take two dictionaries, D1 and D2. Now the very first query is 1 and 3. Means operation is 1 and value here x is 3. So what we will do here, we will append this value in D1. So in D1, the value got appended as a key and its occurrences is only 1. So we are done with this one. Now this D2 is dependent on D1. Now we have to treat this value as a key for my D2. So how to get this key for my D2? So in D1 we will go for the key 3. Now this will return as 1. Now I will treat this returned value as a key for my D2. So it will look like D2 for 1, and we will simply update with the value plus 1. So it will look like, let me delete this one. So it will look like 1 is updated with value 1. Now we are done with this first query. Second is, operation is 2 and my value is for y is 3. So we have to delete one occurrence of 3. So if you see here 3 is present and its occurrence is also greater than 0. So we have to delete this one by 1. So it will become 0. Now we have to update D2 as well, because this was dependent on D1 values. But we are lost with this key. 1 is not in my D1 values. So how to get this 1? So what we will do, before deleting this value from D1, we will treat this value as a key in my D2. And we'll first go in D1 and delete this value. Means subtract 1. After that, we will come in D1, and for that value, we will delete that with minus 1. So it will become 0. Now it is okay. Now let us go for third operation. Third operation is, this is my z value. So we don't have any values. For third operation, we don't need to check in D1. We should go directly and check in D2. Taking this z as my key. So z equal to 2 is not present in my D2 as a key. So this is also done. We'll go to the next query. So for the next query, we have operation 1 and my x value is 4. So what we will do here, we will add this 4 here and its occurrence is how much? 1. Now we will treat this value as a key in my dictionary D2, and we will update this value with 1. Now next is, again operation is 1 and my value is of x is 5. Now 5 will be treated as a key and value will be 1. Now if you see here, we have occurrences for 1 is 2. Means value for 1 is a 2 in my D1. So we will treat this as a key for my D2 and update the value with 2. Now it will go for next query. Again it is, operation is 1 and my value is 5. So for 5 it will update with plus 1. And this will be treated as a key in my D2. And we'll update the occurrences with 1. Now if you see here, for key 1, here 1 have occurred only once. But in D2, we have treated this 1 as a key, but here occurrences is changed. Means it is still showing 2. So we have to subtract here also 1. Means when we update the value in D1, then we at the same time we have to also change in D2, because D2 is dependent on D1. Now let us move forward. Again the operation is 1 and my x value is 4. So if you see here 4 is present, so we have to update this value from 1 to 2, and again we have to treat this 2 as a key for my D2 and update this value 2. Now you can see here 1 is not present as a value in my D1, but for D2 1 is treated as a key, because initially here the occurrence for 4 was 1, but now it have changed to 2. So we are changing in D1, so at that same time we will change in on D2 also for the previous occurrences of 1. So it will change to 0. Now let us move forward. Here the operation is, so for this operation 3, that 3 was not, the value of 2 was not present initially, so it would have returned initially 0. Now again we are here. Now here you can see my z value is 2, so we have to directly go in D2 and check. Yes, 2 is present over there, so it will return 1. Now let's move for the next query. Here the operation is 2 and my y value is 4. So 4 is present over here, so it will update the value in D1, and at the same time it will be treated as a key for my D2 and will be updated with the value 1. Now initially this value was 2, so we have to take this as a key in my D2, means previous key, previous value as a key for my D2, and go and update with minus 1. Now we are done. Let us go for next operation. So it is again 3 and my z value is 2. So this will be treated as a key in my D2. Again, yes, 2 is present and the value is greater than 0. So it will return 1. So we have to return this 1 as my answer. So you can see here they have written 0, 1. So we have to update this D1, and at the same time we have to update D2, and again we have to update D1 if something has changed. Means let me show you with another example. Suppose we are doing add operation, means operation 1, and we have value in D1 and D2. Suppose my operation is 1 and value is 5. Operation is 1 and value is again 5. Operation is 1 and again value is 5. So what we have to do here, we have to treat this 5 as a key and update the value with 1. So we have to treat this value as a key for my D2, and we will update the value 1. Now next time again the operation is 1, means addition, insertion. So what we have to do here, we have to update this value with 2. Now we have to treat this value as a key and update this value with 1. Now if you see here, previously 1 was here, now it have changed from 1 to 2, correct? Initially 1 was there, that's why the occurrences for 1 is 1. Now for the second operation, which was again insertion, so it has changed from 1 to 2. So we have treated this as a key and updated our d2 with occurrences 1. Now again we have to change this d2 previous value. So what we have to do? So how to get this key means after updating this value with 2, we have lost this key 1. How to reach this key? How to reach at this key 1? Because if I go d1 dot value which is 2, it will return me not 2 but d1 of 5. So it will return me 2. Now if I treat this returned value as a key for my d2, it will look like d2 of 2. So d2 of 2 will return me 1. But how to get change this means update this value for key 1. So before updating in d1, what we have to do, we have to first update in d2 for the previous key. Means before updating in d1, we have to first update in d2. So if you see here, d1 of 5 is how much? It is only 1. So this will be treated as a key in my d2. It will go in d2 and subtract the value. So for addition, the very first task is you have to go in d2 and perform subtract operation. Now we have to go in d1 and we have to update the value with plus 1. Then you have to go in d1 and do a plus operation. Now we have to treat this as a key and update our d2 to 1. Then we have to go in d2 and update this value. So now if you see here, in my d1 we have only one value which is 5 as a key and 2 as a value, and this 2 is treated as a key in my d2 and whose occurrence is only 1, and for this key 1 my occurrence is 0, which is of no any use. So we will write one condition: if in my d2 that key is present and that value is for that key is greater than 0, then we will only return 1. So we have to apply these 3 lines of code for my addition. Now let me take for the subtraction also. Suppose we have 5 present with occurrence 2 and 3 is present with occurrence 1 in my d1. So in d2, occurrence for 2 is how much? 1, and for 1 is 1. Means this will be treated as a key. Now my next operation is deletion, which was 2. Means we have to delete one occurrence, 2, and this suppose value is also 2. So here my y value is 2. So you can see if we first delete in d1, then my this value will be deleted and it will become 1. Now the value got deleted means updated with value 1, means subtracting 1. Now this value will be treated as a key in my d2. Now if you see here, this key is already present. Now we'll update this value with 2. This value got changed with 2. Now if you see here, 2 is also present in my d2 with value 1, means initially it was present, that's why we have 1 as occurrence. But how to get this key, how to reach at this key, as we have already updated this value with 1. So before changing in d1, we have to first go in d2 with the previous key. So let me write here, means from d1 dot value which is 5, it will return me what? 2. So I have to go to that key in d2, it will return us 2. So I will treat this as a key for my d2. Now value for this key 2 is 1, so first we will subtract 1 from here, so it will become 0. Now we will come in d1, we have changed in d2, now we will come in d1 and update our value, means we have to subtract 1 frequency. Now we will update here 1. Now we are done. Now again we will treat this as a key and update our d2. So d2 will be updated with 2. Now it is showing correct. In d1 we have only 2 values whose two values 1 and 1. So this will be treated as a key. So 1 is treated as a key and occurrence is 2. Here 2 is present as a key, but its occurrence is 0, which is of no use. So what we have to do here for operation 2, again we have to perform first. In D2 we have to perform subtract operation. Then we have to come in D1 and perform subtract operation. And again we have to go in D2 and add the value. Means after changing in D1, the occurrences for other value increases. So we have to treat that as a key and go in D2 and update the values. So we'll perform these three lines of code for operation 2 and for operation 1. These three lines of code. So let me first write the code. It will be more clear here. So we will take another dictionary which will have the values counter. Means it will treat the values of D1 as a key in my dictionary values. Means this is my D1 and this is my D2. Now for operation 1 we have to perform these three things. So how to get the key for D2? So for D2 what we have to do here, first go in D1 at that key. So this will return the value from my D1 which will be treated as a key for my D2, and D2 is dictionary val. And what we have to do here, we have to perform subtract operation, subtract minus 1. So minus 1. Next time we have to update our D1 means dictionary with the value with 1. Now we updated our D1. Now again we have to update D2 with the updated value in D1. So for dictionary of the updated value in my D1 will be treated as a key for my D2. Now we have to update with plus 1. Now we are done with operation 1. Only these three things were to be done. Now same things for operation 2. Subtract minus 1 in D2. Again we have to subtract minus 1 in D1 values. And again we have to update D2. So before that we have to check the values. Like here we have said, if the values present is greater than 0 only, then we have to perform the operation. That's why we are checking here. If the value is greater than 0, then only we have to perform the operation. So this will return us the key for my D2. So I will treat this as a key for my D2. Returned value, and I will subtract 1. Now again I will update my D1 with minus 1 and update my D2 is with updated value. The value which we got after updation, it will be treated as a key. The dictionary of val value will be treated as a key for my D2. So I have to update this value with plus 1. Now we are done for operation 2. We have to first perform operation in D2, then operation in D1, subtract operation, and again we have to update with plus 1 in d2 with new updated value. So we are done d2, d1 and again d2 with updated value. Now for operation 3 we have to only check in dictionary 2. So what we will do here, we will check if value present at key, which is value. In D2, this is my Z value. You have to treat that value, means Z value, as a key. We'll simply go in D2 on key Z, and if that value returned, value over that key is greater than 0, then we have to return 1, else we have to return 0. We'll simply append this in our result set. Means RES. Correct. Means for Z values, we'll simply go directly in D2 and check if the value present at that key is greater than 0, then only it will return 1, otherwise it will return 0. That's why we are saying 0 is of no use here and here also. At last we are returning the result. So let us run and see. So you can see here it is working. So let us submit this code. So it is running for all the test cases. Let us see what happens. So congratulations, we are done with all the hidden test cases. So initially this test case 11 was failing. So we have just changed our logic, as we have used two dictionary and applied the below logic. So if you have learned something new, so please do like our videos and subscribe to our channel Coding Card, and stay tuned for the next video. Thanks for watching.